Yeah.
Makai Jordan helps assemble a merchandise rack at More Than Words in the South End. He actually helped build the bookcases, too. None of this was here when he started nearly 3 years ago.
No bookstore, no glass storefront.
Now a manager for the book-selling business, the 24-year-old Roxbury native has come a long way in a short time.
So I never had any intentions of getting a real career.
He had dropped out of high school, gotten in trouble with the law. The final straw, he says, was getting stabbed.
In a toxic environment, making toxic decisions, that happened just like that.
In an effort to change his path, he got his GED, but getting callbacks from jobs was tough, until More Than Words. All the youth hired here are system involved.
They're either in the foster care system, court involved, homeless, or out of school. They come here to work on two jobs.
The first is selling books, which are all donated and need to be sorted, processed, and shipped. The youth learn those skills. Their second job is working on life skills. More Than Words staff helping to support individual goals.
It happens here in Sunapee, New Hampshire, known as Sunapee since 1850. It was named after the Algonquin word meaning Goose Lake, since the lake attracts so many wild geese to its waters. Located 45 minutes north of New Hampshire's capital, Concord, little town is host to scenic waterfront views, great skiing, and absolute rock stars like Aerosmith frontman Steven Tyler, acclaimed documentarian Ken Burns, and the baddest grandmother of five.
I'm Kathy Merrill, and I'm a five-time world champion arm wrestler. Well, the first time I arm wrestled, I went to this county fair. A friend of mine, Jim Dooling, who was my business partner at the time, said, well, let's go check out the arm wrestling. We went up there, and I was like, I don't really know if I want to. So Jim said, I'll pay the entry fee, and if you win, I'll buy you some fries. Well, you're not going to not do it for fries.
After winning her first match, she was hooked and began training with a group in Manchester called Granite Arms.